that the only thing that can be proven is with science. And I said to him, I said, look, now in my opinion, I said, I'm a theatre believer. I don't believe in ghosts because I've never seen a ghost. So therefore, I don't believe there's an Allah up there or there's a God up there because I've never seen him. But people can turn around and say to me, but I've experienced Jesus Christ coming in and taking my soul. I'm not going to deem you or shut you anything like that. Well done. I am so grateful that you managed to turn your life around. But don't you dare stand up there and then preach about your religion while saying that your religion is superior to everyone else's. No. In the Quran, in the Bible, in every religious book, it says we are equal. We are one. So why is he then standing up there preaching when he claims to be the number one preacher of their fucking religion and saying that Cristiano Ronaldo is superior to Islam, to Hinduism, to Sikhism?
There's a lot of people like take like small like parts of like their religious beliefs. That's what they mean.
If I want to base my conclusion on science,
of the religion, for example,
do you agree that
that's what it gets, like your whole religion.
Do you agree?
It's not what the religion is like fundamentally.
It's the teaching. The most important thing about religion is the respect, the loyalty, the teaching, to not steal, to not lie, to have morals and ethics. Not to fucking stand up there and say that Christianity is superior to everyone else.
My question is, what is scientific evidence?
Whoa, now you say churches. Why is it that priests, who are meant to be the figure of God, priests, you know, imams, priests, all of these people, why is it that there's been several cases of priests raping children in boarding schools? If he is the true believer of his religion, and he is a true preacher of his religion, why is it that he is then going behind stage and raping kids who are 4, 5, 6 years of age? Why? Tell me that. And if I had the confidence, I'd fucking go up and say that to him. But I don't have confidence in front of all of these people.
Can I say something short? Yeah. I mean, I like the way you talk to him. It's very beautiful. I'm not gonna lie.
Thank you.
But there are a lot of sexism and groups in the world.
Yeah, there are.
For example, from what I practice, it's called Islam.
Like the guy and
exactly.
About,
okay.
Like,
Islam means from the word Salama. So when you're Islam, you're an agent of peace, or you work for peace. But how do you get that peace? You get that peace by Muslim means someone who submits the inner self to the one true divine creator, Allah. Right? So now, you can call, for example, animals submit themselves to God and God alone because they expect everything from God because they have different realm of understanding of what God is. So they are true Muslims compared to any other human. So when it comes to, for example, Jesus said, submit yourself to the creator. Think about, for example, Buddha says, submit yourself to the light.
Yeah.
Right? So if you submit yourself to the one true divine, what happens from there is that we become agents of peace because we receive peace from there. So God says in the Quran, for example, do not cause sex and grooves, right? Because it's bad for us.
Bad for us.
Exactly. What happens? Politics gets into it. We divide. We turn into teams. For example, football games.
And we turn against each other.
Exactly. Like football games. Manchester United against another team.
Chelsea.
That team
or
lost, boom,
Chelsea
there's a fight.
Yeah.
Are we going to go in football here?
No, never that.
You know what I'm saying?
But I totally agree with what you're saying. And do you know what creates diversity in this world? Is that there are a lot of religions out there. That's what creates all of us to be different. We all believe in something different. Okay, we might have the fundamentals that there is a God up there or an Allah up there, but you will believe something different to Allah than to what I believe. You might believe that he's got blue eyes and I might believe that he has brown eyes. But what I'm trying to say is you're allowed to have loads of religions, but just don't shudder any other religion and don't ever call your religion superior to everyone else's, because you're not. He might think he's superior because he submitted himself to inner peace.
But that's the nature of the religion, isn't it? They all claim that they're exclusive.
Yeah, they all do, but I don't understand where that's come from.
No, but that's because every religion, they all believe in God.
Yeah.
But when you ask them to define your God or describe your God, you'll get a different answer.
Yeah, exactly.
So religion is not one monolith. Even within the religion itself, like for example, within Christianity and within Islam, you'll find diversity.
Yeah, of course.
Yes?
And that's
because
the beauty about it.
Neither
that is the beauty.
Monolithic.
That is what creates debates. Yeah. That's what creates opinions. That's what creates me and you to talk. I would have never met you two if I didn't come here today to get into this conversation. And that's the beauty of it. You know, religion is beautiful. It is beautiful. But nowadays, religion has been taken to an extremity.
It's become a dirty word now.
It's become such a frowned upon word. Like, we used to come here when I was children, and there used to be 5-6 speakers, one Christian, one Islam, one Sikh, one Hindu, and they all got along. Okay, fair enough, they all had their differences, but they all got along. Now, one can't look into each other's eyes, you know, because it's become something that's frowned upon.
Do you think the media has a role to play in that?
100%.
Yeah.
100%.
Because I think that's...
The media is the biggest culprit in everything.
They are the ones
who twist and turn everything.
But there's also one thing, though, that at the same time, is that when we all say that we believe in God, right? Some people have a whole, like, I'm not saying it's wrong, like, what they that's their own opinion to say that.
Yeah.
But if someone comes up to me, my way of believing God or Allah is that I cannot imagine Allah. Forget about imagining Allah. I cannot imagine anything outside my realm of the physical world. Because if I try to imagine, I'll only put things that I saw in the physical world together and then
to
say
create,
that, exactly, just my own fantasy.
So create your own bubble,
exactly,
whereas reality is here.
Exactly. So some people will say God is a white man with a white beard in the clouds.
Yeah.
Whereby I believe that God is above, the seven heavens above.
Yeah.
And his throne compared to all the universes, it's like a ring in a desert.
Yeah.
Right? So, and the angels carrying his throne, like I might say carrying, but I don't know if they have arms, I don't know if they look like me, but we don't know what they look like.
Yeah, we don't.
So God is so great and so great that he's not even able to come to this earth.
Because, he's beyond our imagination.
He's beyond
our imagination. So when someone comes to me and he says, God is a man, he came down and now he's among us. All right, God is a spirit, they say. I don't believe God is a spirit because we already have a spiritual world. We have the physical and we have the spiritual. So which way is God? Like, if God is about the spiritual, then all the spirits world are gods, right? So it goes against the Muslim. So if I come to you and I try to explain to you and you turn around saying, ah, now this is war because you're trying to, that is what happens.
Yeah, it is. So that's what creates the infuriousness. That's what creates the anger, because one's trying to claim one and another's trying to claim another thing.
I think what the sister's trying to say, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, it's the way they're preaching.
Yeah.
It's like,
is.
You're wrong and I'm right.
No, do you know what he said? This is his exact word.
Yeah.
Christianity is superior to any other religion.
Now, Muhammad in the Psalms, mentioned by Muhammad in, is it Psalms 2?
That is a very bold statement to make.
You'd have to, the way I would see it, in Islam, as a Muslim, I would tell you.
But I don't use that, to be honest.
No? And there's a difference.
I would rather use Isaiah 42.
You wouldn't say it's superior.
The prophecy of Muhammad
is my truth.
Isaiah 42?
Isaiah 42.
In the Quran, the difference is this: you might see some hate coming from the preachers, and we're not trying to say all Muslims are perfect. Like, I'll show you why. In the Quran, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala says to us that when you discuss, debate with them, discuss and debate in the best of ways, and
we're not to get the most out of it,
and we're not to degrade them, because if we degrade them, for example, if I cuss them, they will cuss back, and therefore they will go into sin.
Exactly.
Unfortunately, on the other side, that doesn't work that way. So you may well find there might be the odd Muslim who does it, but then you need to refer them back to the Quran itself, because our own book tells us we don't debate in a vicious way, in a way to insult, you see? So that's the difference in Islam.
That's what they do.
We're commanded not to do that.
You debate to educate.
Yeah.
You debate
because
to...
we believe in Jesus, so how can we cuss him?
Exactly.
You get what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. And for him, this Abbey chick that was up there asked him, you know, like, why is it that Christianity is superior to every other religion? And he turned around and he said, because Jesus saved my soul. Okay, so what happens if an Islamic person underneath him was to turn around and say, hold on a minute, Allah saved my soul.
So I'm superior.
So why are you superior to me?
I think that was the same mentality. People used to conquer.
I don't. His religion doesn't.
He can have a message. He can have a message. It's the way he's.
He likes. It's the way you portray it to other people.
Exactly. Yeah.
This superiority complex is something that is totally against the preaching and the teachings of Islam. Because in Islam, you know, this is the first thing that was dismantled. Because, you know, they had the Arab pagans who basically were, where they had like caste system within them. They had the superior elites who would look down upon the other lay person, and they were the only ones allowed to be entered in certain temples or certain festivals and so on. And this is something that you find in other religions as well. Like, for example, in Hinduism, they have a caste system where they have the Kshatriyas and the Brahmins who are at the top, and you got the Shudras who are the untouchables. So they are not even allowed to be touched. They are considered to be like the filth of the society. But they can't help it because they were born into that system or in that culture. And for their whole life, they'll have to feel inferior. So this is the first thing that Islam, when Prophet Muhammad came, that there is one God, and in the eyes of God, the only one who's superior, who is the righteous person. not your caste, not your creed, not your color, not your tribalism, nothing. Not whether you're an Arab or non-Arab. No one is superior over the other, except by the deeds and by the righteousness.
Amen. That's it.
Okay, so raise your finger and take shahada.
So, but I'm just curious. I mean, so do you believe in God, or okay, what's your story?
So, my nan and granddad were Muslim. Okay. They believe in Islam, they practice Islam,
right.
They prayed, it did everything. My mum and my dad are not so much, like they don't practice, they literally just
join the club.
Believe.
This happens.
Yeah, they just, like we say when we go to bed, Bismillahi Rahman, yeah. We do our prayer and then we go to sleep.
Oh, so they're Muslims but not practicing.
Yeah, so we wake up every morning, we thank God to wake up. Yeah, of course, I'm not afraid.
Same here, just that I wasn't practicing. Yeah, exactly. Same, yeah.
Exactly, so that's what I believe.
So
but then again, me, yeah. Like I said, I'm a seer to believer. As much as I want to say, yes, Allah is true and everything like that, I've had the opportunity to be raised in an atmosphere where I have had the opportunity to listen to everything. Christianity, I've had Hindu friends, I've had Sikh friends, I've had Islam friends. And every time I used to speak to them, there is one common ground. There is one common ground that we are humans, we are sacred, we have one life to live, and there is someone above that.
Yeah, I mean, there's a common morality within all the religions. Actually, not only the religious people, I would say there is a lot of good morality amongst the atheists, those people who don't even believe in God.
Yeah.
But the thing is, it's kind of not, it varies, isn't it? Between
limited.
So one atheist morality might differ from the other atheist morality.
Yeah, and that's why, with me, I'm stuck at the moment, like, I don't know what to believe. Like,
so the difference.
Lack the knowledge. I've been there. Many of us have been there.
I'm lacking knowledge.
Many of us have
been there
because our parents, see, the 60s and 70s were a time where it's time to put a suit on and forget about religion.
Yeah, exactly.
And now the message is spreading again.
Exactly.
So don't say that, sister. What it is it's just a lack of knowledge. Now, our advice would be, I would believe, is gain that knowledge and analyze that.
No, I've read the Quran.
Alhamdulillah.
I've read the Quran and I know. All the prayers and everything like that.
It's just. You have questions.
When you say you're.
Unanswered.
Same here. Yeah. Join the club. All of us have been in this boat.
Yeah.
But the difference, there's two paths you can take. One is where you just see something, you don't get it, and you reject it. Now that's just blind.
Yeah.
The other one is you actually see something, go and find the information.
Yeah.
Now, again, even when you do find the information, it's totally up to you whether you accept it off the people. Look, for example, if this gentleman is talking to you, we have to judge, don't we, that is he got some kind of, you know, I mean, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, his attitude,
what is he trying to sell?
That's normal, yeah. You know, that's what you do when you speak.
If you're truthful, all I can tell sister is, look, you're truthful in the way you ask for information, but by what I can see,
listen.
Seek the information and be truthful to yourself.
Listen,
I think you'll find the answer.
Listen, there's one thing that I will stand among everything, okay? In the Quran it says not to lie, not to steal, not to harm yourself. But okay, I smoke. And I regret starting.
You all have faults.
You all have
faults. I haven't found anyone who doesn't have a fault yet.
But one thing I will say is that
none of us are angels.
Lying and stealing, to me, is the biggest sin.
Yeah,
even from your parents, your family, even from your friends. Even from people that you don't know.
Yeah.
In the Quran it says we're all one. We're all equal, all brothers and sisters.
What's that for again?
I turn around to say to you, I don't know you. I call you a brother.
Oh, I see.
But lying and stealing, you're taking from another brother or sister. That's your family, man.
MashaAllah,
that's your family.
That's the issue.
That's how you're going to take from one of them.
Okay, that's even worse.
Exactly. It's
worse. Hence why the Quran says there are rules. See, some people say, what's that rule for? What's this rule for? There are rules in place for, as you said,
ethics and morality.
Ethics and morality.
That's why. And that is the teaching of Islam.
How much are we? How much are we?
Inshallah.
Jannat al-Firdaws, inshallah.
Everyone concentrates on the bad. Everyone concentrates on the bad. And the media portray it.
As you said.
That's human nature. For example, if you're driving a car and you take a really good right turn, do you think people will say, wow, look at that right turn, fantastic, you know? It's only when you hit someone or you take the wrong turn.
Like, oh my, okay,
exactly,
you need to stop doing it. Exactly.
So it's the wrong things that you do that gets
the attention.
That gets the attention and that sells the papers.
The
and especially if it's mixed with lies and with like the way the media does it, yes, they portray
a few people
like the ISIS or someone, and they think, look, the Muslims are like that, and then the politicians start, and then the hate preachers start, as you have seen over here. This is not the way to do it.
No.
In order to create peace and harmony, yes, you actually do not consider those people to be representing the mainstream.
Through with our own religion.
Absolutely, I agree. And we all have our share of black sheep, you see. We all do. Whether you're religious or irreligious, you'll have bad people within that. So, I mean, going back to your, I think you mentioned something about you only believe, you only believe what you see.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, trust me, if that was the case, living our daily life would be very difficult. I'll give you one example.
I agree with that, but
yeah.
It's so big, like the statement of there is a God and there is like, I don't know, the statement of there is one above us, that's a very big statement. Like,
it is,
to say that he created all of us, that is a humongous statement. For that to be different than to say, okay, there's a ghost right there,
yeah.
It's completely different, you know. That one, Allah is on this end of the spectrum, yeah, and a ghost is on this end of the spectrum. Yeah. It's completely different, do you get what I'm saying?
But
so I understand, I'm a seer to believer, 100%, but the statement with God and all these religions,
I mean,
Allah and some
one thing in religion you need to put into, really consider is the fact that there is faith in something which is the unseen. If Allah came in front of you, it wouldn't be much of faith, is it?
No.
Because you're seeing Allah.
Yeah, exactly.
But the whole
that's
idea
the
of
reason.
Yes, the whole idea of this world being a test for us, yes, which is a limited time from 0 to, I don't know, 80,
you
90,
have
100
your
years,
time, you
whatever
have your
it is.
Script, and what you
yes.
do with that is what you choose
and,
to do.
And if
that.
You read the Quran and if you read what is prohibited in there, what is permitted in there, it is good for you as an individual,
listen,
good
let
for
me
you
tell
as
you
a.
One thing. The Quran, the Bible, and all the holy books that are out there is there to give you a road, a path to take down.
Absolutely.
Whether you choose to take that path or not is up to you. Whether you choose to put your trust into religion, it's up to you. Okay? That is what the beauty of religion is. It's up to you. No one is ever going to put a gun to your head and say you have to be Muslim otherwise
exactly.
I'm going to shoot you.
That wouldn't be much
choice.
Of a, yeah, that
it's
wouldn't
a choice,
be much
right?
of a
exactly. It's a choice. And that's what allows everyone to be so different and to have different ideas in their head and ideologies, but that also is what brings people together.
Yeah.
Is the people forget,
that's what we've been told to discuss.
People forget that the Quran and the holy books is just a road. It's a path. It's the right
It's guidance,
path.
Basically.
It's a guidance.
It's guidance for
it's
the right
guidance,
to the right path.
To go to the right
Absolutely,
way.
Absolutely. Yeah. No, you got it perfectly,
like,
perfectly right.
I don't understand why it has to be blown up any more than
politics,
that.
I think only the Quran will guide me to the right way.
Yeah.
Only.
Yeah. Okay. Because you're Muslim, right? Yeah.
Even so.
Yeah. Exactly. But that, but then that person over there will say the Bible is the only thing that.
I think what we need to do, sister, is when you have a book, you read it. And you filter through it, and you make
your
decision, isn't it?
You make your decision.
Do you know what I mean? Because there is a truth. If there are three boxes, one of them has something under it, not all three are going to be empty. So our job is, and hence the test, is to differentiate, analyze, have a look, relax, and have a look what the truth is. And you're doing a good job. You read the Quran, alhamdulillah. Now, if any brick walls that you come across, like I came across a few brick walls, instead of ignoring them, I actually took a little peek.
You
I climbed up, took a little peek, and I saw actually what I thought is not what I thought.
Exactly.
So,
you know
that's
what,
the best way to learn.
Well, I think is this though. Sometimes what we read or what we see in the books is beyond the books.
Of course.
All right. For
that's
example,
why you have imagination.
Exactly. But sometimes, you know, when you read the Bible, for example, some people say there's signs in the Quran, blah blah blah. It doesn't matter. But what does the meaning of sign? What does it mean in Arabic? I don't know if you speak Arabic. In Arabic, when you say signs, you say ulum, ulum, which means knowledge. So if something contradicts knowledge and understanding and rational. That doesn't mean like, because at the end of the day, God, when God created Adam, he was given a mind.
A mind.
So
a
when he was given the mind to understand the consciousness, that's when he was put to a test about the apple and that kind of stuff. Whether he's gonna, you know what I'm saying?
That's why we have freedom of will. Like
free
we
will.
Have our free will.
Exactly.
Whether we choose to go against that is our choice.
But about,
I choose to go and kill someone.
And that's why Allah has given you the guidance to show you what is
right
and what is not right.
Exactly.
And this is what's important. But you see this with regards to the different religions. We do acknowledge there are different religions. Yes, but there's only one God. And there are certain religions we say there's more than one God. Yes, but at the end of the day, we have to actually, like the brother said, we have to read and analyze based on
and
the intellect. Based on the intellect that God has given
logical.
You. So what would be more logical? I mean, imagine this. If you had like more than one God, Allah gives an answer to that in the Quran. Because if there are two gods and they both want the same thing. Say, for example, they both want sunset now. And one said, no, I want sunrise now. And the other says, no, I want sunset now. Remember, they both are God. They're both equally powerful. So you see, there'll be...
There always is going to be differences.
There'll be a battle
Listen,
between them.
We're all different.
Yeah.
Our minds all work in a different way. We all believe different stuff. So there's always going to be a point where someone's going to come up to you and challenge what you believe, right? Yeah. There's always going to be an opportunity for someone to debate their side of what you believe, and that's the beauty of it. That is the beauty of analyzing the resources that you have. It's ultimately up to you whether you choose to effort. Read one book, or you choose to go through all the religions and read all of the books, and then make the analysis.
I think the latter would be kind of impossible given our limited life. So what I would suggest?
Well, I mean,
there are 400 million religions or something.
Yeah, but I mean, Christianity, Islam, the ones that Sikhism, closest logic the main ones. Yeah. It's your choice. Yeah.
So that's what I'm saying.
You stick, go and just stick. To
what you need
God,
to do is you need to
you go and read other
need to look at
well.
The monotheistic religions. Yes, like the Abrahamic faiths. Most of them preach that God is one. Now again, within those monotheistic religions, obviously there's differences.
Yeah.
Otherwise, they would all be called the one name.
Exactly.
But they are different names.
The same. Yes. And
So what do you do is, like, for example, I've read the Quran, I've read the Bible, and when I look at the Bible, and when the Christians tell me that God came down as a man and he was killed by his own creation, I say, hold on, there's something wrong with this picture. Because when God in the same Bible says that he's immortal, he doesn't die at all. And then another version says of that same Bible says that he was not only killed, but he was killed by his own creation.
Yeah.
And he died for 3 days and three nights. Either he's immortal or he's immortal. You can't have it both ways. So you need to be consistent. You see, one of the principles that is advocated in the Quran is Allah giving you this acid test. Allah says in the Quran, if this book is from anyone other than God, surely you'll find discrepancies in it. Surely you'll find contradictions in it. And you see, this is the same rule that we apply to the Quran, the same rule we apply to the Bible, the Old and the New Testament, and the other religions. Because you see, if something is from God, God doesn't make errors. God doesn't make doesn't have contradictions. And this is quite clear from when we read the Quran. Yes, it has stood the test until 1400 years. Yes, in order for anyone to come and pinpoint any contradictions in the Quran. This shows, you see, the language is Arabic, but it's being translated into many languages. It doesn't mean it's only for the Arab people. No. It's for, obviously, it had to become.
Just research your sister.
It had to come down in one language.
Because you're an honest person, yeah. So inshallah.
So, I mean, just to clarify, do you believe in God or you don't believe in God?
No, at the moment, I'm atheist. Well, I'm not atheist.
You're agnostic.
I think
I'm agnostic.
Yeah.
You're not sure which is the right path.
Like, I don't know.
Research, sister, research.
It does. It comes down to whether I want to go out and research it.
Yeah.
But then again, I think there's, at the age I am at the moment, I have more priorities to use.